and therefore we've decided to add in eFootball to our PES brand.
It's kind of meta, right, that we're in a situation where you have a video game about a sport that is now an eSport.
Yeah, no, exactly. And you can definitely, our fans can definitely be excited for more eSports news moving forward.
Yeah, I mean, I would assume that there's going to be community announcements, and to foster an eSport, you really have to be community-minded. So what have you kind of put into the game, or what are you thinking about for your roadmap that you think you could really roll out an eSports scene?
We definitely put it this way. In the background, we are working on our plans. They are final.
Sure.
We will announce them in the next couple of months. But all I can say is, when you look back to the past, especially last year, we had our PES League competition, which is a competition for the wider audience. So me, you guys, you can join the competition. You can qualify for the World Finals. But then on the other side, we also have our competition called eFootball Pro. So that's obviously, there's a little link to it. And eFootball Pro is a competition which is for professional football clubs. So you have clubs such as Barcelona, Celtic, or Monaco playing in that competition and playing against each other for the big title. So that's those two competitions are obviously just the start of very exciting eSports projects.
You know, another sports game that I think you probably could look to for inspiration, or maybe for what they're doing wrong, is NBA 2K League. Have you thought about deeper partnerships with different leagues or teams, like you had mentioned?
We are doing this already.
Okay.
So besides obviously working together very closely with our partner clubs, we are also working together with the leagues. So for example, just 2 weeks ago, we did the Cyber League. So all the teams, all the Russian football clubs from the Premier League, from the top league, they competed against each other to play for the Russian championship, for the Russian winner. And that's definitely something we are exploring more and more in the future.
You know, I think a challenging thing, like I mentioned, for a year-to-year kind of game is the game changes sometimes. You guys introduce gameplay elements, remove things, change things around. Sometimes you flip around the lob pass button and the pass button just to annoy me.
Yeah.
How do you think about going forward, especially with your eSports initiative, making the game transition from year to year as helpfully as possible for your core fan player base?
I think, first of all, I agree with you what you're just saying, that obviously if you release a game on an annual basis, it's difficult, I mean, to add new elements to it. But I would say this year with the new PES, we've added loads of gameplay elements to the game, which our esports players, but also our normal PES fans, they can definitely look forward to it. And those gameplay elements will have a huge impact on how certain esports athletes will play the game in the bigger competitions. I've already received messages from certain players who actually asked me, when can I come to the office, or can I play the game? I really want to see it. I really want to look forward to it. And that's, for us, the perfect sign that this game will be really, really big this year.
And I think another really important thing for any esport, any game, is that it needs to be easy to pick up and play. Have you guys done anything in the recent years, or even with this version, that you think can help open it up to new players who might see promotion for your esports and say, okay, maybe I should get into this? I think like a game like Rocket League is a good example of that, where it's really easy to enter in, but it's very hard to master. Mm-hmm. Can you talk about like that onboarding? Have you thought about expanding the player base?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, I mean, in terms of like our esports plans, we cannot go into detail, because that will come later in the next couple of months. But what I would say in terms of when you look at esports, what is really interesting and something where we just explored it or noticed it in the past is that co-op, for example, especially for football video titles, something we introduced last year. And co-op means that you will play with two other friends together. And this, especially when it comes down to offline events, this is something which has become really interesting, because you have all the emotions, obviously, when someone is winning or obviously when they're losing, it's something completely new, which hasn't been there in the football video game scene before. So that's something from an esports point of view is really interesting. But in terms of the gameplay, we've added loads of new features to the game. We worked with Andres Iniesta. He's Barcelona legend. He's now playing in Tokyo. Our development team worked with him very, very closely to bring our gameplay forward. He shared all his feedback, all his football knowledge with our development team to tweak the gameplay here and there. We've included a new dribbling feature, which is called Finesse Dribble. And this, it's named after him because he's very well known for his dribbling skills. And that's what we added to the game. There are new modes coming to the game, updated modes. So there's huge amount of content for for current users, but very importantly, as you said, also for new users, so that we can introduce them to our product, to our brand, and actually can provide them with a wide portfolio of content.
Yeah.
I'm interested in hearing a bit more about the decision to rebrand, because I imagine for such a legendary known franchise as PES, that had to be kind of a difficult decision, you know, thinking about how do we get the word out to players, our partners. Could you tell me more about what went into that decision and how you've, besides being here with Shaq News, of course, how you've been spreading the word?
I mean, first of all, that's been, I mean, as I said earlier, that obviously esports had a huge impact for us. We are present in the world of esports for the last, obviously, I would say 10 years. We started small. We had those little tournaments in hotels somewhere. And for the last 2-3 years, we went actually bigger, where we worked with our partner clubs. We hosted events at Barcelona, at Arsenal in their stadiums. And that's definitely the right direction where we want to work. We want to get bigger, work with all our partner clubs. And therefore, for us, esports is very important. And with this repositioning, with the change of the name, it is something, some sort of statement we want to make. However, the brand PES, the terminology PES, is still something we still want to keep, since, right, as you said, it's a heritage. It's something, right, obviously everyone, like I grew up with PES, with the brand.
Same.
And so,
yeah. Yeah.
So therefore, we still want to keep it in the brand name. And we've decided then to make a combination and call it eFootball PES moving forward.
That works. You know, I imagine it was kind of the right time too, because coming up on another 10-year marker, PES 2020, that's a big deal for any sports franchise.
Yes, no, definitely. And I mean, even though it's PES 2020, obviously there are years to come. Next year we have our anniversary of the series in general.